Everybody, this is Hisasuke, and today we're finally taking a look at Hive, a Wardog faction raider with an emphasis on lifesteal and deadly close quarters capabilities. As always, abilities are up first. Hive's power comes from her ability to impregnate her enemies with unique pheromones that, when in proximity to Hive, will attract the attention of her little ones, swarms of microscopic alien parasites that burrow into the skin and siphon the life force from her foes. All of her weapons work off of this combat template and require initial impregnation before she can siphon essence for ability. When lifestealing, the white bar to the right side of the HUD will begin to fill. You can press the ability key at any time to tap into this emergency life reserve, which will immediately heal Hive for any missing health, and even overheal up to 300 health points depending on how much of the essence bar you have filled before activating. This ability makes Hive a huge threat when engaging her in close quarters, as she can feign weakness before unleashing a surge of secondary health to continue the fight. Learn to take advantage of the effects this lifesteal delivers, and shoot multiple enemies at once to build the meter faster. Each weapon affects the range and proximity of your leech effect, so take some time to get used to their distances. You can leech enemies through walls, floors, behind cover, and even on the move. You can sometimes even run into groups of smaller adds and just dodge in between them until the little ones finish their work. This ability is both leech and the heal, so becoming familiar with its ebb and flow will allow you to effectively maintain a higher degree of survivability than most war dogs. It should be noted, however, that activating Hive's essence heal ability causes her swarm to return to her body, filling her with the gathered essence. As a result, the parasites will cease their tick damage to any previously infected enemies until the bar is completely depleted. Hive's weapons are often corrupted or infested variations of various mercenary weaponry, transforming their original attributes to suit her unique and parasitic needs. Her first option is the infected MM6C, a fully automatic rifle, I guess you could call it, that rapid fires pheromone pellets at enemies from medium to close range. It has one of the more limited leech ranges, so you'll have to get pretty close to feel the weapon's damage properties come into effect. But its high rate of fire guarantees that you'll plant seeds in multiple adds at once. It's a good starter weapon, but compared to some of her later tools, it doesn't really stack up. This weapon, however, can be built towards effective and caliber. Second on the list is the Raceme, or the Raceme, or the Raceme, or however you want to call it. The Raceme works a bit like a long-ranged mine launcher, deploying large spore clouds that siphon health from enemies at great distances. It's a semi-automatic weapon with a slow rate of fire, steep projectile drop, and a small clip size. But its negative attributes are balanced very well with its damage capabilities. Once deployed, the Raceme can leech from multiple enemies within the spore cloud, who will suffer consistent damage over time. If you manage to drop the mine in tactical objective locations, heavy traffic routes, or even fortified enemy positions, you can keep a steady flow of damage and essence gain to prepare yourself for the inevitable push. The Raceme is also great in CQC scenarios, as Hive can drop a mine at her feet in preparation for an enemy rush, which will pretty much guarantee her success in the encounter, as the enemy will have life constantly siphoned from them while they're brawling. And Hive can always panic burst or heal at the last minute to regain footing in the encounter. It's mechanics like these that make the cons of fighting Hive up close far heavier than the pros. The Raceme is a monster of a weapon, and raiders should definitely be wary of its presence on the field. Can be built towards Caliber, Hero Killer, and Exterminator. The third option in Hive's bag of infested goodies is the Wasp, an initially complicated shotgun variant that finds its strength in close quarters leeching. The Wasp fires scattered seeds that can impregnate enemies like usual, but unlike her previously mentioned weapons, the Wasp's effectiveness increases the more you damage enemies with it. When firing, you'll notice a small graphic near your crosshair. This icon will fill up slowly based on the amount of essence extracted and damage dealt. The leeching effects of this weapon are much shorter than other weapon choices, and will require you to hit multiple enemies at once in order to effectively manage leech potential and conserve ammunition. You can always spray at crowds of enemies, that's definitely a viable option, but also be mindful that, once the meter's full on the wasp, the shot grouping will become tighter and the damage will increase. Filling the bar completely will peak the weapon's damage output and distance, but once you reload, the bar will be reset and you'll have to build it up again. The bar will not reset if you haven't reached maximum potential, so try and reload before peaking so you can get the most out of every bullet in the clip. This weapon will feel confusing at first, and even explaining it feels confusing, but once you get it in your hands, it'll all make sense. I don't recommend using this weapon at higher MMRs though, because its risks far outweigh its reward. But it can be effective against smaller and easier to manage enemy groups. It can be built towards caliber, automatic, and lethal.
Now last and certainly not least is the weapon you've probably been getting one shot by whenever you see a Hive antagonist, and that's the Shy. A bit of a misnomer based on how often this gun shows itself. The Shy is a powerful long range crit beast that has a fairly decent leech range, but a nightmarish damage output for anyone on the receiving end. This weapon is a 4-round semi-automatic variant of her first weapon that has an additional function, a projectile shield. The shield builds up naturally and very quickly over time. It can be ejected with the alternative fire key and moves in the direction you're aiming. The projectile's movement speed is slightly faster than a war dog's sprint speed. It's great for forward pushes on fortified enemy locations and blocks a lot of hitscan projectiles. Turrets, shotguns, missiles, and snipers will have a hard time stopping you from rushing them. This weapon's unique function is powerful in the right hands, and can be used to surprise enemy raiders that may be expecting to shoot you preemptively before a brawl, and find the tables turned when it's you taking advantage of the situation. Try sending the orb in the direction of a known threat in the distance while you fight another raider. Send the orb to block enemy projectiles to cover a teammate, or block those fletchet rounds while you're uploading Olive. It's this addition to Hive's toolkit that's meant to help her close the distance and get in close to what she does best. Shy can be built towards caliber, lethal, and effective. One last thing before we wrap up on the weapons, Hive's arsenal is very different from other raiders, and her weapons can often penetrate enemy photon defenses like in place turret shields, Mika's barrier, Lycus's kinetic shield, etc. So have fun with that. Alright, so when it comes to cards, Hive thrives on bloodsucking and brawling, so I build her to accommodate that. I want to punish enemies for getting close, and turn the decision fatal if they choose to damage her. That's precisely why I use the Wardog faction card, Exacerbated, which amplifies her melee damage significantly after receiving damage from an enemy. With this card, if Hive's received damage in the last 4 seconds, her strikes deal 60% more damage at base, and 300% more damage with an Olive super boost. When pushing up on an enemy, 4 seconds is really all you're going to need to finish the job, and with the amount of adds on field, it won't be hard to find a stray bullet to help get the pain train going. When it comes to character cards, I use one called Corrosive Pheromones, which increases my damage against swarm impregnated enemies by 6% base and 20% max. This card combination works extremely well when taking on multiple raiders, with the Racium in particular, as they fight on your terms and suffer tick damage the longer they stand by to kill you after an iframe execution. Perfect. Which leads me to the next topic. As an antagonist, Hive is a primary target for raiders, more so than most due to her constant stress state and known threat status on the board. Take advantage of the natural aggro you'll receive and distract raiders from completing objectives so your AI compatriots can spawn in and swarm the map. Hive is very efficient in 4v1 situations, a lot more than the other cast. Her CQC mind games rival Mika's, as raiders will often anticipate your inevitable dodge after receiving hits and go for a grab, but you can then turn the tables on them with an essence heal burst and take the offensive. And this is against a player who caught you off guard. Speaking of, ambushing raiders will be a bit trickier as Hive due to the fact that you can't hide, but by that same token, you can count on raiders coming to your location. But whether you're on the offensive or defensive, land those impregnation shots before the fight on as many raiders as you can. This will make attacking you a conscious decision that can have fatal consequences if gone about the wrong way.
The invincibility frames after an execution are dangerous enough as it stands with any reader, but Hive's ability to fire off any impregnations before getting back into the fight pretty much confirms success for her chain kills. If you've got the Raceme, hit the floor beneath you and follow up with strikes. If you have accuracy-based weapons, land a shot on the closest raider and follow through with the same. Even if a raider chooses to dodge, the swarm doesn't care and will often down the opponent before they even have time to complete the animation. When facing a Hive antagonist, know that her strengths lie in close quarters combat, so engaging her from a distance is ideal. CC abilities and anything that can knock her off balance or limit her mobility are necessary in dealing with her. Good counters include Valeria, Constantine, Ayana, or even a good Ginebra. Hive's weaknesses take the form of high stress gain and limited reliable range capabilities. The Shy is powerful, but smart players that manage to use cover efficiently, keep their distance, or flank Hive will see positive results. Her Raceme, while dangerous, has a slow rate of fire and steep bullet drop that can only take advantage of held up raiders who don't stay mobile. Hive is an infectious and dangerous raider, as an ally or an enemy. She brings a confidence to up close and personal combat that's only rivaled by a few other raiders. Her survivability and unique combat style make her an aggressive and fun raider to play. Thank you for watching, Raiders. I hope this overview gave you some insight on how Hive functions and hopefully helps you make an educated purchase. Hive's current price is 52,000 gold as of the August 24th patch, and could change after this video is up, but she's well worth the current price. Why is she worth less than a blueprint? Anyway, thanks for watching, guys, and as always, I'll see you all on the Broken Planet.